how do you practice abacus in your abacus time so you could do so well?
Okay, I think my ma'am is here and around. So I was a little adamant in understanding and taking challenges to a certain extent. Okay, I mean, a little back to the SIP story, I would say the one couple of things which I absolutely found, why do I have to do this, is that I have to actually use the abacus. I'm like, no, and this is problematic. In fact, I always enjoyed doing things entirely in my head. In fact, also like restricting. And I remember very, recall it very rightly, that there was this one time where I actually like put my both hands in a glove and said, and caught them like this and said, now you're going to do your calculations, okay? So doing this is not cool. This is not cool anymore. So, okay, now let's try this hand up. Can you do your calculations? So, obviously, see, at the end of the day, I think abacus is an entirely different world by itself, because there's a lot which can be done. And to be really honest, I think regardless of wherever you're from, having an abacus edge makes you far ahead in this run of becoming the fastest human calculator or whatever.
Correct.
I mean, the people who are with me in the Mind Sports Olympics who have scored second and the third place don't necessarily use Soroban or abacus. But the edge is there. So, So I mean, what we have to understand is that I think the structured challenges which, let's say, the institute or the set of people who engage with you give are fine. That you do anyway. That's something which is well put. But I think being a little deviant also helps. Saying that, having the unorthodox approach and say, okay, I ideally should not be able to do this, but if yes, how? And I personally found my inspiration from reading books and majorly searching the internet, because I'm not sure how many people are here from academia, but there is this one paper from engineering which is called Numerical Methods. I think you would agree, about it. And that's something which I absolutely found very, very fantastic, because regardless of the complexity of any problem, it could be boiled down into the basic five operations which you're good at.
Yes.
And this approximation techniques are things which will make you beyond what you already are.
Mm.
And I think a few other interesting parts about things are, let's say, memory. How can you recall 100 numbers at the same time? Because at the end of the day, there are a lot of things, right? Cognition is not only about being able to quick compute. I mean, if I have to put it in a very layman term, your computation is your RAM. But your memory is your hard disk. Jahan process slow hote hai, processes are slow, but they retain. They are there for a long time. RAM is when quick things happen. So the working memory and the long-term memory are very different things. So understanding that, acha, for me to solve this problem, let's say I'm adding 20-digit numbers or multiplying 20-digit numbers. Now, for this to happen in the abacus way, I would have to probably remember a 21-digit number, another 21-digit number, and 20 such 21-digit numbers, and then finally come to the answer. And I think, GMC people, you understand what I'm saying. So, in this way, optimization is a way which you go about. I think optimization is to understand, everyone understands what computer optimization is. Brain optimization is understanding your limit and saying that I will still solve this problem by using whatever space I have in my head.